to get lined up on the back chute. These boats are not near as fast as some of the competition boats today. And as I said, with the water conditions, when they get rough, it's really hard to drive them. These things don't turn well with the narrow transoms that the old boats had. The only boat out there that had even close to being one would be considered a wider transom was the Calypso. And Jeff's just letting them get set up right now. He'll be up with them here about the time they get around to the end of the front chute. But everybody's trying to get lined up. Ready to make a start here in just a minute. But as you see out here, we have the Jones Hole, the white boat. We have the Hopeville gray home in the middle. And then the one on the outside is Frank McLeod out of New Zealand. We're now filtered down here in Ascot. Coming by right now. You can see Jeff carries a lot more speed. Considerably better ride than the other boats have, but Jeff will catch up to them. They'll come down the back chute, and coming up on 1 minute right now, they're a little bit behind where they should be and where they want to be. We have three people out there that are former racers in the first, second, and third place boats right now, and the fourth place boat is the non-racer who's immigrated from New Zealand to Canada and running a New Zealand boat. That's Paul Russell, the Kiwi. If you get a chance to talk to him, he is totally and completely a hoot to enjoy his conversation and company. He's been a great addition to our vintage family that grows every year. And we actually have some younger members starting to join us and get involved in some of this. And if you're back here in 2 weeks, for Mahogany and Merlot, you'll get a chance to meet those people. 15 seconds to the start. Right now. down there. And as you can see, Paul Russell starts to back up a little bit on him, and that boat does not turn down well. He doesn't carry much air underneath it, and when he gets down to the turns, it gets a handful at times. So for the winter, I know he's going to have some air traps, try and make the boat run a little bit better. Still out here trying to get the Tiger II around. I'm not sure what the issue is, but it looks like it's sputtered a little bit, but he's still after it.
Everybody else had a great time. Jeff Snyder would come around the turn fast. And